Howdy ho, folks. It's the Smoking Pipeliner, also known as the most trusted and reliable source for tobacco reviews anywhere else in the world. You are tuned to the correct station. All these other channels that like to review tobacco, I don't think they're trustworthy. They will lie to you, folks. In fact, they will probably say the most hyped blends are the greatest blends they've ever had because they've been already hyped up. And yes, you must go out and buy them right away because they're just so marvelous. Oh, everybody loves this, and so do I. It solidifies the fact that I bought all this tobacco, and I'm so popular now because I love this tobacco and everybody else loves this tobacco. Oh, I fit in. I fit in. Oh, I fit in. So today we're going to be reviewing, you know what it is, because you clicked on the video, didn't you? Yes. The new Kringle Flake by Sutliff. Sutliff, as you may know, as everybody knows, shocked the pipe tobacco world with a release of a limited edition holiday tobacco. I was like, holy cow, limited edition. Oh, I was get out of my way. Women and children flung to the side. I was diving into my office just in time, clicking, bunch of mouse clicks, click, 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 to secure my limited edition Kringle Flake by Sutliff. That's how serious this was and how serious I took this just to get this tobacco so I could review it. Because, of course, nobody sends me tobaccos anymore to review. Why? Because I tell the truth. These people wanted to pay me off. I'm telling you, all these tobacco companies tried to pay me off with favorable reviews. And guess what? I didn't give it to them. So, of course, they stopped sending me tobacco. So, I guess the joke's on probably me because I'm still buying the tobacco to review it. So, I'm just doing it out of the kindness of my heart. That's how much I love you guys so much out there that I buy this tobacco to review so you know what to do. There's nobody with that kind of kindness anywhere in the review world. I can clue you in on that right now. So, with that being said, we're going to review this tobacco. Now, due to the time-sensitive thing, I needed to get this out before Christmas, which, by the way, well, I'll say the whole Merry Christmas thing at the end of this video, in case that's the finale. Of course, there's going to be a finale. So stick around for the big, big Merry Christmas sign-off. And as we keep going, we haven't even got to the tobacco yet. This is just the announcement of the tobacco. That's why it was such a huge ordeal. Kringle Flake. How could you not love the name? And nothing really too crazy about the label, but it's kind of cool. You could address somebody on here if you wanted to. I don't have any close family relatives that smoke tobacco. Unfortunately, my influences only kept them away, I guess. I don't know. I don't go around promoting pipe smoking that much. I just am a pipe smoker, and that's my thing. Anyway, Kringle Flake. Let's open it up. I did take one. I had one bowl of this 2 days ago, and I will hold back my review on that because I'm going to try it again. Now, I have some sitting out here because I wanted to dry it out. Now, unlike all, I'm trying to think of any other flakes that that Sutliff makes. This pretty nice looking flake. Now, it looks hard to transform onto video, but I was expecting it to be in the same shape as like their crumble cakes were, but it looks like they pressed down into a pretty nice plug and then cut these really, I mean, these are real thick, meaty flakes, but not like their crumble cakes are. These, when you touch it, just don't disintegrate. They stay in flake form even despite being very thick. And they're very, very wet, which may have been the problem on my first smoke. Yeah. This one I've had sitting out for 2 days. I'm going to try on this review. So really, my second impression of this tobacco is going to be the final verdict, because it's time sensitive. You know, after Christmas, this is, you know, I just throw all the holiday stuff away, including chocolates, all that stuff. It all goes in the garbage, so this will be joining them. Probably, you know, because it's a holiday thing. You know, you got to move on, new year sort of thing. Discard all the old stuff, get rid of it, get on to more, you know, fresh new startings of the new year or whatever. So, do you guys treat your tobacco the same way? So, anyway, the smell, it's got that weird, subtle smell. Now, it has dissipated since I opened up the lid, but you put the lid back on and open it back up, it smells. Not necessarily good. It's got a funky smell. That's a smell that you don't like. Funk. No. Funk music is good, but funk smell, not good. Now, if you're into funky smells, just keep it to yourself, okay? So anyway, I'm going to load my pipe, then I'm going to review this tobacco. Hopefully, soon, it might take a while to review. This video is probably going to spiral completely out of control. It has already, has it not? It's probably because I haven't made a video in a while. You know, there's just a lot to say. You know, I feel great, you know, being back on here. Next year is going to be a really big year, I promise you. Maybe the biggest year in smoking pipeliner history will be in 2020. It's a big year. You'll see why. Lots of surprises coming your way. Anyway, let me load the pipe. So, loading it in my Brevia Ninja, which, if you have to buy a briar pipe, are you guys still messing around with them briar pipes? Haven't crossed over to the mirrors yet? Well, been caught red-handed smoking a briar. I still have a few briars around. And if you're going to smoke a briar, smoke a Brevia. Because Brevias are a really good value pipe. Better quality briar. And they're not too expensive. You know, most of them can be had for $80 to $120 range. Of course, they've got some that are more expensive. But I love the Ninja. This is one of my favorite pipes, and it smokes a lot of different tobaccos very well, especially Virginias. And anyway, I tried this blend in a Meerschaum a couple days ago, and it did not work out very well at all. Now, it could be because the tobacco may have still been moist. Even though I dried it for a whole day, it was still somewhat moist. It was not a very good smoking experience in that mirror. In fact, half the bowl, I had no taste going on. I just had the heat, and just not good. I set the pipe down, came back to it like an hour later, thinking, well, maybe it'll be better after sitting in there after. No. I think maybe towards the end of that bowl, things were getting to be civil, at least, and I got some flavor out of it, and still, was not impressed on first round on Kringle Flake, unfortunately. What is Kringle Flake, by the way? I'm just jumping the gun here. Kringle Flake has Red Virginia. It's a Red Virginia Flake, which is why it intrigued me. Everybody loves them Red Virginia Flakes, and that would be everybody including me. I'm a Red Virginia fanatic, in fact. In fact, I might buy some pom-poms. Red Virginia. Yeah, go Red Virginia. We want Red Virginia, right? I'm going to get some pom-poms. I need a cheerleading squad for my channel. Maybe that's coming in 2020, too. I'll be the first channel guaranteed to do tobacco reviews with a cheerleading squad. I'm taking applicants. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see what filters in, you know. We'll see what happens. Back to the review. This video is completely gone. Now this time, it's going a little bit better. Now these flakes are so thick. That's another problem too. You have to kind of like break them down and kind of twist them up a little bit. Otherwise, it's trying to like stoke an actual oak log in your pipe, you know, it just won't get going. It's going a little bit better this time around, I must say. Still, it's not like blowing me away either, as some other red Virginias do. See, I don't like doing these videos where I haven't really smoked this tobacco too much, and I'm trying to give an impression either. That's why I usually smoke a whole bunch of times. I already know what the tobacco pretty much is going to taste like and what it's going to do, and I kind of tell you. So I'm telling you, the first time I smoked this, not good. Second time, a little bit better. It's got, what is that taste? That's that Sutliff taste. Sutliff coats their tobacco in something. I don't know what it is. But it has a distinct taste, and you can taste it in pretty much all their blends. I will be right back with the verdict of this bowl. How about that?
We're waiting.
Well, the verdict is, I don't think it's really that great, unfortunately. I really wanted to like it, like the name, like the concept, like the fact that it's a Red Virginia, but unfortunately, maybe these Red Virginias are just still not really red yet. They're just a little green. They're green Virginias, maybe. I don't know. Maybe this stuff just needs a lot of age. So we'll have to check back in like 10 years and see if the holiday edition of 2019 was worth buying or not.
In the year 2525, if man is still alive.
But right now, I don't know. I'm probably gonna have a hard time smoking through this tin, so I may jar it up and then revisit it next year. Maybe have a bowl after it's been sitting and aging a little bit more and go forth from there. I don't want to waste my time smoking stuff that I really don't like. So, oh, that's right. I was going to discard this anyway with all the Christmas candies that I'm not going to eat, or I probably will eat them all. Oh man, it's almost diet time. That's right. Join me on my next video as the smoking pipeliner is going to be getting into your diets. Yes, smoking a pipe and dieting. What this means for your weekend at 10. What this means for your new year at 10. I want to wish everybody a very Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays in general, and a very Happy New Year, because I doubt I make another video before the new year strikes. But when this new year gets rolling around, I'm telling you, big plans for this channel. You just wait and see. You thought I was gone. Some of you were so happy I've been gone. I'm back. That's right. I'm back. I will be back. Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye. Okay, bye-bye now.
There's just no taste. I don't know what it is. There's no taste. And the taste that you get is the funky taste. Yeah. Not impressed. There's just no taste. I don't taste Red Virginias. Are there Red Virginias in this? It says Red Virginias. Is there Red Virginias? Where's the Red Virginias?
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.